PC one. As you told, I wrote a book, and you may be wondering why I wrote a book on this language. It was accidental. The sense that when I was SP Kannur, there was a violent case against school authorities. In Kerala, more than 5,000 schools are now considered uneconomical, and they are being following Malayalam medium education, and they're closing down. To tide over that problem and to maintain the vacancies, what the teachers do is that they go to the Wayanad and take the students from the Wayanad Adivasi area, that is tribal belts, from this Yegadiyabhaya Vidyalaya. That means only one teacher will be there, but many students, different classrooms. So they used to bring the Adivasi students from Kayanad district to Kannur and enroll them in the schools to show that they are a part of the school, so that they can maintain their teachers' positions. So the tribal students are initially encouraged to come to Kannur, another district, primarily by saying that you will be studying in English medium, we will be providing you accommodation and everything. So these tribal children, around more than 100 children, are brought from Wayanad to the Kannur. And they were brought and kept in one Malabar English medium school, and next day were put in a Malayalam medium school. So the children got agitated and told that we want to study in Malayalam medium, English medium, where do you want to put me in English medium? So it became a huge problem, and SFI, other student unions took a march to the management and smashed the classrooms, teachers, etc. So it became a police case. Now it is our task to investigate why it happened. So it is a social issue, but we took up the investigation. It was initially taken up by the Wayanad DOSP, that is DOSP, which is entrusted with scheduled caste atrocity cases alone. So after some time, we told that this is not our police investigation, this is a social issue, and we closed it down as something which is recorded. There is nothing we can investigate. But unfortunately, in my mind, I was just thinking about that issue, because I was always want to know. When you look at the children, you wonder, these children are actually not Malayalam speaking. Initially, they were actually Paniya, Sanadiya, they were speaking their own language, and they were not even fluent in Malayalam. When they were put in Malayalam medium school, they also don't want. The most important question is this one, whether if you provide Adivasis and all schools, make it as English medium, will it be successful? Or will it make it everything as Malayalam, will it be successful? Why is so? So this is the question we want to answer. At the same time, there was a Supreme Court judgment also. K.G. Balakrishnan sir, the ex-12 Chief Justice of India, now the Human Rights Commission chairman, he told that since students are studying in Malayalam medium schools, they are unable to get even clerical jobs. Students who are studying in Indian language mediums won't even get clerical jobs. This is also pronounced by the Supreme Court of India in this Bangalore English medium schools, this is Kannada State government schools. So that actually wanted to explore why it happens. So in this particular aspect, I started investigating on my own when I became a commandant from SP to commandant K4. And then this book came up. And before talking about this book, let me say something about this one also. Science education is intrinsically linked with this book, because science as such, I was mentioning, as a knowledge creation, information. Science is nothing but a knowledge, one type of knowledge. And knowledge to the common people, knowledge to the researchers and everybody. So who creates knowledge? Knowledge is created in the universities, research institutes, and it is disseminated to the common people for the welfare of the people. So example, for agriculture, farmers, they need knowledge. Science, they know, they want to know what type of crops is most suitable in that area. How much water they have to supply, what kind of breed they need to put in. Similarly, they also want to know what type of livestock is more milk yielding, how to maintain that, what kind of food we can gather, and more importantly about the market condition also, climate conditions. Whether if I plant this particular crop, will it give me an adequate price, stability may be there. So all these things are linked, knowledge. The sense that if you create this knowledge in the economic atmosphere and disseminate to the common people in their own languages, that is more important. That is, science communication in Dravidian language or people or common language is more important primarily because it is intrinsically linked with economic and human development. So when I started this one, I want to understand, before 7 years we were under the British rule. Not only we, but also most of the Asian countries were under some form of colonial government. Only after the Second World War we all became free. And along with this, there were many other Asian countries which also became free. Like Korea, China, Indonesia, all became free nations only after independence. And after independence, these countries took over two different directions. One direction is that India, South Asian countries, India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, and Malaysia and Philippines wanted to pursue knowledge creation and dissemination in English language. There is a colonial language groups. There's other countries which like China, Indonesia, Korea, Vietnam, and Taiwan. These countries wanted to pursue their education, knowledge dissemination, everything in their native languages. So after 50, 60 years, I want to know how much these countries has developed, whether it has adequately, profited the people in every aspect of life. So to my surprise, I was found that the countries which always communicate in the language of people which understand knowledge, science, or whatever the case, become more prosperous, more developed than the rest of the countries. It is proven by the statistics. So example, knowledge is created what? Knowledge is in the form of, I'll just start from the beginning, like knowledge is created in the form of books and websites, magazines, etc. So I want to take up this particular countries primarily because one set of countries like Anglophone countries of India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, which have higher education in English alone. So example, in India, medicine, engineering, law, everything is offered, management is offered only in English. Similarly, the case with Pakistan also only English. Bangladesh is only English. Whereas in Korea, right from the pre-primary education to the higher education, whether you are pursuing a medicine, engineering, or law, it's only taught in Korean language. China, only Chinese. Taiwan is only Chinese. In Vietnam is only Vietnam. Vietnam is only Vietnamese. Indonesian only in the Indonesian languages. So, if you compare the number of books published, number of knowledge created in the forms of number of books published, it'd be very surprised to know that all these countries have a huge number of books are being published in all these countries. Similarly, in European countries also, which pursue higher education in their own native languages. When I selected language, number of languages which are using their tongue in higher education, you can make out that only Indian languages and Arabic and Malay languages are excluded from higher education. If you take the top 30 language groups, which has more than 3 crore population, out of these 30 languages, 3 crore population, each, around 12 are Indian languages, including Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam. All these countries have, all these language groups have more than 3 crore population. That is much more than what a ordinary European language population has. Like Norway is only 40 lakhs. Or in Iceland, only 3 lakh population. But they also pursue higher education only in their language groups. And if you take the number of books published, you find that in India, total number of books published in a year is only around 70,000. That also, the figure is not correctly with the government. It is given by the Books Association. There is a number of books published in other countries, in terms of per capita, is much, much higher, at least 10 times more than that. And similarly, if you consider the number of copies sold, each books published in Korean language, Korea is published around more than 20,000 books per year. And of that, good number of science books, technology books, only in Korean language. And Malayalam, which has an equivalent of population, or Telugu, which has more than twice the population of Korean, does not publish more than 5,000 books. Similarly, if you take the Thai language or Indonesian language, the number of books published in these languages are much, much higher than Indian languages. And then comes to the modern phenomenon of websites. I found that I was so distraught by the number of websites. You know that what is the total presence of Indian language in the cyberspace? It is less than 0.5%. That is, in the South Indian languages are spoken by 1/4 of the global population, which includes India, Pakistan, Bangladesh. All these places are Indian language populations. Bengali or Urdu spoken in Bangladesh and Urdu in India also, Pakistan also. So the number of website of Indian language groups is only 1,247 according to the Indian Mobile Association, Mobile and Internet Association of India. And as per, if you want to know about the number of websites, what is the language dominance in the cyberspace, it's always available on the internet. There's internet statistics website is there, internetstatistics.com is there. Then web information coming is like alexa.com gives you what are the websites which are prominent in particular countries, in which language are prominent, it's all given. And if you look at that one, you'll be surprised to know that in all other parts of the world, it is only the websites in that respective language which dominate their cyberspace. Only in India, of the top 100 websites, exclusively everything is in English. Whereas in Chinese, China, if you take all 100 websites are in Chinese only. In Russia, it's all in Russian only. In Germany, all in Russian, German only. Even the multilingual states like Switzerland, we have many language groups also. In language groups also, you find that German speaking, only German is there. Because German is allowed in higher education. In French speaking area, the French is allowed in higher education. In Italian speaking area, Italian is allowed. So even irrespective of the nation state or of monolingual or bilingual or multilingual, European countries invariably go for the people-oriented approach wherein they provide information in the language of the people. That's a democratic principle. They say that the language in which you seek vote should be the language of official communication. That's the policy. In court, the petitioner comes with the language and does not know the common language. The judgment copy also should be in the language of the petitioner. The language of the court is the language of the complainant. Whereas in India, it is the opposite case. There was a case in Kerala when Italian marines killed fishermen. They went to the court. Normally, captain level officers are always English speaking in India. But Italian speaking, they were only speaking Italian. They want to know what is going on by in Italian language. They wanted to get the judgment copies in Italian. So in the High Court of Kerala and told that no, you can't do it. In India, only English is allowed. Whereas in European countries, irrespective of your language, even if you are giving application as a citizen of Sweden, that court, Sweden court, has to give you a reply in Malayalam or Tamil or whatever language you are entitled to. So because there's democratic aspirations are much higher. And similarly, this knowledge creation, apart from knowledge creation, if you look at the developmental activities, whether these countries, which countries are developed, we say that we are fully equipped because knowledge is in the English language. So we all study it. We use it in higher education. That means that we should be more developed. But what is the situation now? You take the educational attainments of these countries, Anglophone countries and native language countries, so I found that in the countries which follow their own language in higher education are educationally far, far better than the Indian states. For example, every year the OECD countries, Organization of Economic Cooperation Development, conduct a survey throughout the world regarding the student efficiency in reading, mathematical skills, and comprehension, science. So this competence is taken into account by administering a set of questionnaires throughout the world in their own language or own medium of instruction. And in 2010, it was administered, and India is not a part of the OECD. Only 30 well-developed countries are part of it, and we are a partner nation. So along with India, China, and other countries, in 2010, they administered this PISA, Program for International Student Assessment Test, throughout the world. And they ranked the countries according to the educational attainment of the children. It'll be surprised to know that out of the 73 countries which participated, the best educational system is available in East Asian countries and European countries. In Europe, it's Finland and Sweden. These countries are top in educational attainment. So in the world, it is the Shanghai students in China are the most efficient, highly educationally well qualified and competent was shown. And out of the 73 countries, India came as the 72nd country, last first one. I was wondering why came the last one. I found that last one was called Kyrgyzstan. Kyrgyzstan is the only country which follow like India, they still study everything in Russian. Whereas the common language is Kyrgyz. So they also don't understand like us. So, and then again, Wipro came up with another same approach. They told that we will administer the same questionnaire to the top level English medium school students. So let us see how they are doing it. So they selected the four metropolitan cities and administered the same questionnaire and found that our top level English medium students are below average than the average students of the world. They are no way compared to the Chinese students are the same. So this is a common educational attainment. Let us see the another thing. So example, every year we conduct, we have once in 4 years, we have Olympics. Do you know that every year they have Olympiad, subject Olympiad, mathematics Olympiad, physics Olympiad, informatics Olympiad is being conducted throughout the world. And we also send students that. In 1989, we sent our contingent of students for the first time for this Olympiad, subject Olympiad, mathematics, physics. That time we were around the 25th rank. And Korea and China were 40, and Thailand was much lower. Now, if you take 2010-13, all these countries have more gold medals in Olympiad than us. And the top country for the last several decades is only China, Korea, Taiwan, these countries, which take their exams in their own language. You know, if you want to understand mathematics Olympiad, you are allowed to take in your own language. Chinese students take mathematics Olympiad in Chinese language. Koreans take in Korea. Whereas Pakistani students take in English. Indian students take in English. Bangladesh students in English. Malaysia and Philippines also. All these countries are nowhere near to the Olympiad medal ranking. Because we are far, far behind even the smallest countries. Understand that? And if you want to know that, is it because of our script? We are complicated script because our language is not suitable for this one. You'll be surprised to know that Thai language's script is derived from Indian language. They say that they derive from even Telugu. Because they same Abujida, that is A-A-E-U, that's there in Thai language also. And Thai language websites are everything only in Thai. And they conduct communication in Thai only. And then if you look at the school level education, you are backward. What about the university level? Because university level, we all conduct everything in English. So naturally, we will be producing more research papers. Our students make more competent, become more better scientists. But unfortunately, university ranking by the even Times Educational Magazine, that's by UK magazine, as well as where the Chinese one Java University is there. They also conduct international ranking of the universities. In the international ranking universities found that not even a single Indian university is in the top 100 ranking. But you find that Korea's Institute of Technology, which is like IIT, which teaches only in Korean language, is top. I mean, one of the 100 universities. Or you find that Peking University is one of the 100. Chongqing University is one of the 100. And you will be surprised to know that the best medical college in India is AIIMS. And the AIIMS ranking is much lower than even Thailand Medical College, which teaches in Thai language. Got it? So all these countries in terms of the population may be less, but in terms of research output, if you take, this is research output also. It's a sciencewatch.com where you can understand, where I can go and see the ranking of the countries in research output in mathematics, physics, chemistry, all research ranking is given by the sciencewatch.com, Thomson writers. And in that you can always see what is your ranking. India's academic papers are cited so low and considered to be extremely low quality. Whereas people from Korea and other countries are considered high quality academic outputs. Even in areas where we think that we are more competent, like in computer science. Some say that computer science can be taught only in English. Why? How can these Koreans can come up? Koreans not only learn English, they also learn, if you look at the Korean websites, etc. You'll be completely surprised by the number of knowledge, the amount of knowledge you create in the language and how it is being disseminated. Here they learn, they'll try to get information from everyone. We are trying to get information only from America because we know only English. Whereas Koreans get even from China and Koreans get from Japanese. So the website, if we take, top websites are, you have Japanese website, Chinese website, they, people learn many languages and try to get input from everywhere because knowledge is not an open source. Knowledge sometimes is actually secret. So knowledge is created in clusters of industrial areas. So example, Silicon Valley is famous for software. Similarly, so example, if you want to know the latest technology on nuclear medicine or nuclear technology, then French, you should know French because France is the most foremost pioneer in nuclear technology. Almost 80% of the energy in France is from nuclear energy alone. But if you want to know more about the water precision technology, then you should know Hebrew because Israel is a pioneer in Hebrew technology, irrigation technologies. They advise us because that's how they create knowledge, because they creating knowledge for common purpose, their own use. They create knowledge and patent it. Somebody may be inventor, but innovation takes place, then they patent it and make sure that they commercially viable and sell it as a product and services throughout the world. So Americans might have discovered a TV, Americans might discovered IC chips, but who is using it? Japanese and Korean, Samsung, Toshiba, now Chinese companies are coming up and they are exploiting the knowledge. How can they use it? Because they rely on the strategy whereby they don't give knowledge creation for everybody in English. The two strategies, one is that you can, knowledge is available in languages, okay, in English, good. Our strategy is that make everybody learn English, let them all assess knowledge. Whereas Chinese and other countries, what they do is that knowledge is available in English. You put a translator, one or two people, make them translate and give it to all people in their own language. So crores of people learn without even learning the language. Whereas we do the other anachronical thing. So what happens is that we are putting all our energy in learning small words, verbs, grammar, etc. and trying to become a master of language and trying to become without understanding what is science or technology or without the classroom atmosphere gets lost. So naturally you find that if you look at the human development reports are published by the United Nations and the World Bank development reports. All these reports point out that countries which have higher education in the native language are progressing much faster, reducing poverty at a greater rate, and the people are more prosperous, healthy than the rest of the world. I'm not giving you so much of diagram, but you can go to my website gramam.net and you'll find the data. Then the issue is that is good. Then next question comes, whether what type of, how to disseminate it, whether our Indian Dravidian language is competent enough. This is a big myth I want to explore. Because if you look at the ancient buildings of India, if you go to Tanjavur and see the Tanjavur Periyakoyil or Brihadeshwara temple, you'll be wondering, how come this before 1,000 years back, this Rajaraja Cholan built it? Is it because he was knowing about knowledge, English was important for his architecture? And if you go to the Vijayanagara Hampi, you will be wondering how much beautiful building they have made. Do you think that Vijayanagara were using English for this architectural purpose? But lately, before some years back, two IIT students wants to make a design for Sauchalai, that is Kakus. Sauchalai in Indian language. They came up with a novel idea saying that Indians don't use toilets. This is because of toilets habits only, they get a lot of diseases. So they wanted to make a project, and they want to make a project in their own language, Indian language. They say that Hindi people are not doing it, so we are Hindi. So we will make a project report in Hindi so that it can be disseminated to everybody. And IIT told them nothing doing. Your project cannot be in Hindi, Indian languages, it should be only in English. English can be used for science creation and knowledge creation. Your thesis is unacceptable. Okay? Just think of the case. We had Taj Mahal and so much of building, Kalana, all these things. That time we were using Indian language. Suddenly our bureaucrat says that you should not like Indian languages or even for toilet building. So that means that who is responsible for the hotel? It is not the bureaucrat, it's not even the politicians. Politicians understand the situation. is that we have this national policy makers who are mostly academics. They are still not aware of the fact that rest of the world teaches their language for knowledge creation and disseminate knowledge creation in their own languages, and they are more successful. So because of that ignorance or because of that need for elite standing, what I call it, as Jayashankar Master was telling about some prestige language, because the economic interest is very high. So example, in the rest of the world, what happens is that a doctor produces a set of papers. In India, a doctor produces a paper in English, and they can only communicate with them. Whereas in Korea, it is a doctor produces a paper in Korean language, and is accessible to everyone who knows Korean language. It means that patients can interact with the doctor Korea in Korean language, and Korean language return the manuscript, everything for prescription. They can access the website in Korean language. And in that case, when the doctor and patient know the same language, the doctor fees is less. Whereas in India, the doctors speak in English, the patient speaks only local language, so he feels ignorant. So when the ignorant is there, then you pay more fees. Similarly, for lawyers, throughout the world, the court activities, by law, it says that law should be understood by the common people. For that, it should be in the local language. Whereas in India, however you try in court, lawyers won't accept local languages in court. Because if they accept local language in high court, their fees will always come down. So they make it as such way that if they want to charge more fees, they should be in English. So economic returns for the elite is more, because if they use in English, common people are unaware, can be more ignorant, and the economic returns is very high. Inequality is very high, because you always tolerate inequality. Whereas if then somebody is asking, sir, what about the terminology, what kind of books they read, how to make a language is competent enough to do it. And you will be surprised to know that Indian languages are far advanced than the South Asian languages before 200 years back. Japanese language, when 1867, Japanese first allowed the ships. So that time the language, they don't know modern medicine. Even Ravindranath Tagore says that Bengali was far rich literature, Tamil had a far literature than Korean or Japanese or these languages. So Japanese were actually promoted or encouraged by the Dutch doctors. There is one island, foreigners are not allowed to get into Japan. They are allowed only on small island, a doctor was kept, Dutch doctors. So from the Dutch language textbooks, they copied Japanese for the first time in the end of the 19th century. In Korea, in Taiwan, etc., English was there. But after 1948, they discontinued English, started Chinese, and they produced a lot of research papers. And how can they do it? If somebody is asking, we can go for the bureaucratic procedure, we are bothered about the terms, terminologies, what kind of words used, how the diction, etc. Now what is happening in other rest of the world? Rest of the world just happens spontaneously. The sense that, for example, I am an economics student. The standard prescribed text for economics is Paul Samuelson's economics textbook. It is published in more than 40 languages, including the Greenlandic language spoken by 40,000 people. But it's not in Telugu, not in Tamil or Hindi also. Because it has no market. In PG courses, you are not allowed to write in Indian languages. Then what is the need? And you are not allowed to produce your research papers by the university UGC in Indian languages. So you won't be getting a job also. Whereas other parts of the world, what they do is that already there is a market, and Macmillan publishes the textbooks. And it only translates it. So, for example, even ordinary books. So, for example, Marquis publishes books. Or Paulo Coelho, he writes in Portuguese, publishes a book. And on the day of publication of the Portuguese book, he publishes in English and rest of the language also. Because the publishers themselves take up the task of translating it. Similarly, syndicated columns, if we take, for example, Paul Krugman, our famous economist, scientist, etc., Chomsky. this Chomsky writes in English. Next day it's available in almost every language of the Western world. You believe it? Because it is done by the private sector without any bureaucratic procedure. It's by the market demand and supply they actually do it. Because already there is a market for it. Then continuously in the private players supply it. There is nobody, there is no one in Japan or Korea to know that what terminologies use it. Because books are being, yesterday Rangan sir was talking. Instead of trying to produce terms, you write books, then automatically it will come. That is how the new nations have come. So, example, Estonia is considered to be one of the most techno.